Thank you. Good afternoon. Very happy to be here. We are going to present you the launch of a very innovative and disruptive product for a company. It's always very important. We did that last year for Electrolyzer. And today, we are pushing the boundaries, which is first to make sure the pointer works, pushing the boundaries of business case and of technology for heavy transportation. Last year, we presented, as I said, a product which was more dedicated to industry and energy, with cutting edge on electrolyzer, to bring the total cost of ownership with electrolyzer below 2 euro per kilo, if you have electricity at 40 or 30 euro per megawatt hour. This year, the goal is for transportation to hit the 5 euro, like the golden number, which brings the parity with diesel on transportation. And that's the kind of solution I'm going to present you. First of all, I would like to thank my colleagues. We are 90 people within McPhee, and this has been organized by the technical team. I see Cedric, who is here, scientific director, who pushed since the last 2 years the product and the communication and marketing team. So it's 2 years of work with a short presentation of 15 minutes. I will start with who is McPhee, just to give you the background of our company. Then I will move to what do we see on the transportation market, what we propose in terms of value proposal, and how we do that, for sure. So McPhee is a 10-year-old company. We have five business locations, three in Europe, one in China, and three industrial assets are in Europe, one in Germany, in Berlin, one in France, where our headquarters is located, close to Grenoble, and one in Italy, in San Miniato, close to Florence. This infrastructure brings us to a capacity of 300 megawatts per year, 50 refilling stations per year, and in the midterm, we are planning to double also the refilling station capacity. We are backed by strategic partnership. It's important. We are 90 people, probably 100 people by the end of the year, but we have strong partners. One of them is EDF since 1 year, who took 21.5% share and is helping us to accelerate commercial and industrial scaling up. Then we have technological partnership with De Nora and Electrolyzer. And of course, we are part of the Hydrogen Council to contribute to innovation. What we did in the last years, we are now in contract 16 megawatts of electrolysis, 21 refilling stations, and the core markets we are addressing are heavy industry and heavy transportation. For heavy industry, of course, the key weapon is to have electrolyzer fast response and reliable, and it's something we will develop also in the coming meetings or technical forum tomorrow. We are part of the 40 gigawatt coalition. I believe Pascal will also develop the Hydrogen Valley initiative. Pascal is our CEO during the public forum tomorrow. And I will speak also on electrolyzer initiative to scale up for bringing more infrastructure facing green hydrogen. And second, of course, is hydrogen refilling station. So McPhee is an equipment provider. We design, we manufacture our own technology, both for electrolysis and station. Now the background we have on transportation, we are going to deliver, this is a station in Berlin, in a Shell facility that's during a job site recognition. We will deliver in November our first station for the German market, 200 kilo, 700 bar. And we are going to commission in June this year our first station for buses, integrating both electrolyzer and refilling station at 350 bar. It's important for us because that's the heart of return of experience, 20 refilling stations, and we have already one in operation, including both electrolyzer technology and refilling station. And this station will bring us to the next step, to have bigger volumes on site. Now, what's going on heavy transportation? I think a lot of presentations this morning were also orienting at looking at what are the key trends. Clearly, we see three mega trends. If you see the current project, the pointer is very erratic. Let's go back. Okay, stable. So you see, these are only the last 3 weeks' news. Norway plans to eliminate diesel engine, combustion engine, in quite short term period. France is doing the same by 2040, at least for sales. We see a lot of initiative for trains, for buses, for trucks, you all know that. And when we look together of what is the common trends on that, I believe now for sure what is obvious for all the decision makers now is everybody is going for zero emission. Everybody is going for energy integration. Energy sector is speaking to transportation sector and industrial sector, so we are more sector coupling orientation. And the third trend is now all calculation converge, that you can hit this golden number of €5 per kilo, which is the diesel parity. So you can do green at €5 per kilo, which is equivalent to 1.3 euro per liter for transportation. But you do better because you have no emission, no particles, and no CO2. Now, how can we do that? And that's the proposal we have within McPhee. First, we looked at what is the key expectation of the customer if you look at trains operator, if you look at bus or heavy trucks operator or retailer or logistic companies. The first, they are looking at bigger scale and common fleets. A scale for trains is probably 10 to 12 trains. For trucks, it's 50 trucks, and for buses, 100, which is usual size of a facility for a big city. So it makes a nice cluster. And all these players are asking for productivity. You need a fast refill time, more or less 100 kilo in 10 minutes. Peak activity, even if you plan, you need to absorb natural growth or peak activity in the day. Maximum availability, 24/7 for sure. And automatic operation, so connected device, unattended. People want equipment, you open it on the morning and you don't need to move it during the day or even during night shift. And of course, from an economic point of view, you need optimized TCO and on-site production. And why we believe on-site production? Because it's to reduce the supply chain. If you produce hydrogen on A point and you have to transport for 200 kilometers, you have €2 per kilo of transportation. It's equivalent to €40 megawatt hour of electricity price, so it's a loss of efficiency. So on-site, when it's feasible, really makes an advantage. While ensuring safety and comfort for drivers and for operator, for sure. So what is our answer on that? When we look at that, we say we need to bring to the market something that really will fit the full, the 360 degree needs. If you look at what's happening on smart city and buildings, I used to work on industry, I used to work for construction industry as well and building. The smart buildings today, they include a full package for end user efficiency, modular, and you have to have a solution which fits all the needs. So we believe, what if the station would be flexible, efficient, connected, and also bringing, for sure, comfort to the drivers and the operator. So we call it augmented McFilling. It's a general concept, as I told, 2 years of R&D, based also on simulation model for modelization, an intense discussion with a panel of players from trains, trucks, bus, and truck makers. We will not name them because we have a lot of confidentiality agreement and pre-feasibility study, and one patent which is under registration. to cover the full innovation of the solution. So this station brings first the production with multi-megawatt electrolysis, which are on the background of the station. Then we have the compression unit, and on the stage two, and then the dispenser, which can be 350 bar or 700 bar, indifferently, depending on the specification and the usage of the customer. This station is modular. It means that it can work for the train. That's the base scenario that we made. But it can work for train, and it can work for buses as well. What is very important is not only the architecture, but the software and the dynamic reconfiguration. So the design of the station is like a hydrogen mini mill to dispatch 2,000 kilo per day. You need to think of the hydrogen flow and, of course, all the data management. So in the pink area, you have what we call the interface or the multiplex interface, like for the telecom, where you group and degroup the gas management. And then we use what we call cascade management as if we had one storage. And we have indeed 18 storage, but they work as in we have one. So we choose what is most efficient to go for the low, the medium, or the high storage technology. And then we decide the coupling or decoupling. Is it better to refill the station directly, or do we need to boost and to go for further compression and higher pressure? Or do we need to give the priority to hydrogen production on the electrolyzer side because we have cheap electricity from renewable? All the software has the configuration in that, and in an automatic way, will give the priority to the end user, but managing this flexibility. So this gives a very efficient architecture with the data management and this, what we call, dynamic reconfiguration model. It's scalable and modular. So what is very important for us is we anchor the design with the train, station, and solution, working with the players in France and in Germany mostly. And based on this architecture, if we move to the truck, we just need to add additional two dispensers. We have two dispensers for the scenario with train. We go to four dispensers with the scenario with trucks, and it fits with the requirements. And we put an additional compression unit. And then if we need to go for buses, where you need high flow of delivery, 100 bus, we will add additional dispenser, and we will go to six dispenser and additional high pressure storage. What is very important is we have still this common architecture to stabilize the quality and, of course, reduce the cost. It's just adding additional units. To summarize, again, for the customer, the benefits is the availability because we have a lean process. It's to be modular, to give this flexibility between the number of the trucks and the production of electricity and intermittency. It's to manage the peak activity. We don't want the drivers to say we are queuing up. We will more welcome them. We'll design also, we think it's good to have a safety and a restroom for them. But there is the boost mode, so we can unlock the capacity if needed. And of course, high energy efficiency. The station altogether with the auxiliaries will be around 60 megawatt hour per 1 kilo of hydrogen to optimize the full TCO. And the system and the software will be connected with the operator through Wi-Fi or 4G, whatever, to lean the flow management with industrial operation. So the benefits will be you have the state of the art. We have a proprietary system with a patent underway, the dynamic reconfiguration with the software embedded proprietary McPhee, and that gives 2,000 kilo or more, because then you can double the system. It's only 2,000 square meter, so you can increase, of course, the capacity with that. If we do that, we believe it's a good way to go forward, really, with the transportation transition, to make it safe, affordable, and making this integration in the different territories, gathering affordable and green electricity. All that we can present to you for more details in our booth. There is the technical team as well. You will find a nice 3D video that shows all the details of the scenario. We'll be very keen to work with you on pre-feasibility study. The product is entering in detail engineering phase, so it will be, it's already, I would say, time to market to building the project and including permitting detail engineering. It could be in service for the first unit end of 2021, beginning of 2022, so 2 years of development roughly to make the project happen based on mature technology on alkaline and whatever good efficient compressor that we can integrate in the system. So thank you very much and welcome in this clean transportation revolution.
Thank you very much, Bertrand Amello. Are there any questions from the audience? Okay.
Thank you. I have a question. Who will be the one who's actually buying the entire solution? Is it more aimed at a final customer, like a from the industry, or is it more aimed at governmental communes and stuff like that?
It's a very good question. Indeed, on the value chain, McPhee will provide the technology, but we believe you need to cover the full value chain up to the end user, and of course, the question of the infrastructure management is key. It can be very flexible. If you speak to some retail company, they are keen to create equity company, joint venture, to run and operate some facility. So it can be private company, it can be utility company, it can be an EDF group, it can be an Uniper group, who have good electricity to valorize and will be happy to get additional value selling hydrogen. It can be the end user as well. We see some end user very interested. In Belgium, you see that Colruyt is investing on the infrastructure. So whatever makes sense. There will be investor because the business case works. And the business case works, again, because the parity is closed. And we need, of course, to have some partners with trucks or bus company. So flexible model, I think, will happen.
Excuse me, let me specify just a little bit more. What's the smallest possible application?
Can you repeat, sorry?
What is the smallest possible application?
We think this station can work at 1,000 kilo on the lower capacity side, but if you have a specific project, we'll be happy to tailor that. You see, we deliver station more standard for bus as the first reference I show for 400 kilo or 200 kilo. So we have the small, medium size to activate the market, and we can go bigger. So very happy to discuss if we need to tailor something.
Thank you very much. Looking at the time, we have to move on, but I see it raises a lot of interest. So if you want to discuss the topic, please go to booth C70, where you can find them all, or you will be around. Thank you very much again.